What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Tom here with EasyWeb101.com, bringing you just a short video on how to install WordPress on Cpanel hosting with Godaddy. Now, this should work on any company or any web hosting company out there that has Cpanel, assuming they have Installatron. Most of them have Installatron. There's a few that don't. In that case, it's usually like Softaculous, I think, is the one, but there's not a whole lot of them that use this, so this should work for most people. So with that said, we're gonna dig right in. We'll make this a short video. So I'm gonna go ahead and shrink this window down. What you're gonna do is go ahead and log into your GoDaddy account. This may be the first page that you see, but if it isn't, go ahead and click this button up here in the right corner and then go to My Products. From the My Products screen, you're gonna scroll down. You need to find where it says web hosting. Click this little arrow to the left. This will drop down and show you all of your hosting accounts. From there, you're going to look, and on the right side of the screen, you want to click the Manage button next to the hosting account you want to use this for. From there, you want to go ahead and click your cPanel admin. That will log you into the cPanel admin. Now, from here, I like to use this search functions thing right at the top here. First thing we're going to do, we're going to make sure if you haven't added the domain to the cPanel already, we need to go ahead and add it. So go ahead and search add up here. And then we'll go to add on domains. From there, you'll see domains listed here that are already attached to your cPanel. If it's not in this list, you'll want to go ahead and add it up here. What we'll do is we'll type in, I'm actually going to use one of my domains that I'm not using for anything, worstmovies.space. I don't know why I bought that still, but anyways, so we'll go ahead and type that in. It'll auto-populate subdomain and document root. Do not change those. Those are exactly as they need to be. Create an FTP account. You can if you want to. There is a root FTP account associated with every cPanel, so you don't really need to. I never do. Anyways, after that, we'll go ahead and click the blue Add Domain button, and we'll give it just a minute. While we're waiting on this, don't forget to like and subscribe for tons more of helpful videos and tips and do-it-yourself tricks. We're always posting something new. Alright, so that took a little bit, but we've got the domain added on. So now we're going to go ahead and click this white cPanel button in the upper right corner to go back to the cPanel home. This time we're going to search install or inst or something to that effect. It'll bring up the Installatron Applications Installer right here. You'll go ahead and click Installatron Applications Installer. From there, you want to click Applications Browser in the upper right here. And then you're going to scroll down, find the WordPress button over here on the left-hand side. Go ahead and click on that, and then we're going to hit install this application. From here, you're going to select your domain, and when you click on this, you'll see a list of all your domains here, and there's a couple that seem like they're duplicates. They are not. Let me explain what I mean. So you're going to see, like, we're doing worstmovies.space. You'll see the worstmovies.test.easyweb101.com. That's that subdomain that it added on back there. This is the actual domain. So you'll see four different versions of it. So this is the actual domain. http://worstmovies.space. Same thing with a www in it. And then also with an HTTPS. Now, you'll want to use the one with HTTPS if you have an SSL already set up for this. So if you don't plan on adding an SSL, don't do this. It'll just mess up the install. And just to clarify, because I don't know why I run into this sometimes, simply selecting HTTPS does not give you an SSL. With GoDaddy, you'll actually have to purchase one, or you'll have to go to another source and find one. Third party, something like that, but you do have to get an actual SSL. You can't just select that and automatically be secure. So in this case, I don't have an SSL for this. I don't need one. This is just a test. So I'm going to select this one. As far as choosing if you want www or not, that's strictly cosmetic. When you go to the browser, it's just up here in the address bar. It'll either say www or won't say www. But either way, if somebody types in the www or not, it will still go to your website. So I prefer to just use it without. Directory, this is where you would place a subdirectory. So if, say, I wanted the actual WordPress install to be at worstmovies.space/blog, I would type that directory in here. Or if I wanted it at worstmovies.space/dev, maybe I'm making a dev site, you would do that. I want it directly on the domain, so we're actually going to make this blank if we want it directly on the domain. So we'll just go ahead and erase that. From there, I recommend leaving all the settings here default unless you know what you're doing. Most people, if you're watching this video, probably not good to mess with these. So leave all these default. Scroll down till you get to administrator username and password. You'll want to type in your username right here. In this case, I'm just doing, let's just do test site and administrator password, whatever. So go ahead and put in your administrator username and password. This administrator email you'll want to replace with whatever email you're going to be mainly using on the site. A lot of times this will get automatically associated with users and sometimes even contact forms and stuff. So make sure you put in a good email in there. Excuse me. So we'll put in this. And then website title. This is what you want to appear. So if you see like how this tab up here says My Hosting or WordPress dash Installatron application, this is what's going to appear right here where it says WordPress or My Hosting, and it's going to be your main website title. So if I was building a site for my business, I might do something like that, or Easy Web 101 test. Website tagline, that's where after this dash it says Installatron application, this is where you would put in whatever you want it to display after a dash. So if I were to build my company website, maybe awesome websites. So, all right. Again, the rest of this stuff I would probably leave default. I wouldn't mess with it. Definitely don't mess with this multi-site thing. That's one thing I get a question about a lot. Answer is don't touch it. All right, and then from there, we're just gonna hit the install button. And we'll give that just a minute. It's usually pretty quick. You'll see this just spin around kind of for a while. Looks like a little barbershop pole or something, only it's blue. All right, and it's installed. Now, if you just added the domain, sometimes the DNS will take a while to take effect before you can actually access the site. It's always like up to 24 hours for DNS, although typically it happens maybe 15, 20 minutes, but you might have to clear your browser cache or something to that effect if you've been to the domain recently. That said, let's see. This, yep, it works for me already. So, by the way, when you're in the Installatron, if you click the link that says WP-admin here, that's going to log you straight into the WordPress dashboard to get started, and you'll end up with this start wizard right off the bat, which I'm going to go ahead and cancel out. But that's pretty much it. We'll go ahead and expand this back up, but it's that simple. So you just go in there, add the domain first, and then you're going to go ahead and do the Installatron install. Like I said, you try to use all default settings, and then go ahead and click the WP admin link and log yourself in and get started. All right. If you guys got any questions, comments, or you feel that I missed something, feel free to leave a comment or reach out to me, thomas@easyweb101.com. We're always here to help. And again, like and subscribe if you want more helpful tips in the future. Other than that, thank you for watching.